Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Peter Pogorski. I love your shirt.
Thanks, man.
You look great, man.
Twinning today.
Fantastic. So you're an intern.
Yes.
It's okay to say that, right?
Yeah, perfectly okay. I'm an intern on the Service Fabric team and I study computer engineering at the University of Waterloo.
Very cool. And you've built something for us. I've done a lot of shows on Service Fabric. I've done shows on VS Code. What have you done?
So today what I'm going to show to you is a Service Fabric extension for VS Code. So what this lets us do is developers can now create new Service Fabric applications right in VS Code. They can build their applications and deploy them to either a remote or local cluster.
That's
all
cool.
From VS Code.
All right. And this is like real. Like this is not a faked demo. This is all really hooked up to production.
Yeah, this is all real. This project's going to be open source and available on the VS Code marketplace. So completely real.
All right, cool. What do you got?
All right, so I'm going to start off by showing you how we create an application. So simply bring up the command prompt, search for the Service Fabric create application command. So now I'll be prompted to select from one of four project types. Either a container application, C# application, guest executable, or a Java application. So what's happening here is we've integrated with existing Yeoman generators, and basically we're able to select what application type we want to create, and it'll build it. Okay. So anytime a Yeoman generator is updated, the templates will also be updated. So right now I'm going to build a C# application.
Cool.
And we're going to name it counter application. So once I give a name to the application, we'll be prompted to select from one of three service types, either an actor, stateless, or stateful service. So the developer can choose whatever kind of application they want to create.
So those are kind of sub-templates within the template.
Yeah, so that's going to be a template within the Service Fabric application.
Okay, cool.
So right now, I'm going to choose a stateless service. And we will call it counter service. So once I do that, the project's going to appear in our workspace here. And I can just open that up so we can modify it. So once we open that up, we're able to write any code that we need to. We can modify anything within the application that we want. And now I can build the application. So once again, I bring up the command prompt, search for Service Fabric, build application. If this comes up, just click restore, not a problem. And then it's going to ask us what type of project we want to build. So in this case, it's a C# project. Select that. And then the output of the build process will be shown in the integrated terminal right here. So it will run a build script. For a C# project, we're going to run an MS build. If it was a Java project, we'd run a Gradle build.
Okay. And I see that it looks like you're inside of the bash terminal there.
Yeah. So this is going to connect with the bash terminal. So when you set it up for the first time on Windows, you're going to want to make sure that your main terminal is set to be bash on Ubuntu.
Okay.
If you're running it on Windows. And this extension works on both Windows, Linux, and Mac operating systems. So you can choose whatever experience you want to use. So now we can see that the build script's almost finished.
You write this extension in JavaScript?
It's written in TypeScript.
In TypeScript?
Yes.
Very cool. Had you written TypeScript before you came to Microsoft?
No. So this is the first project I've ever written in TypeScript. Super cool language. Had a lot of fun learning how to use it.
So that's cool.
That's been great.
All right. So then you've built now building a Service Fabric project is a little different than just building a regular project, right? There's like there's some manifests and stuff around.
Yeah. So
it.
There's an application manifest, a service manifest. So that's all going to be included in the template. And then whenever we modify that and build the application, it will just work.
In the past, when I've done Service Fabric apps, I've had to use Visual Studio proper, which meant I was on Windows.
Yeah, so this makes it really easy for developers on Linux if they want to build a .NET Core application and they don't have access to the full Visual Studio. So it's an easy way for them to develop.
Okay. Right. So I see that the DLL got made, and then I also see something about a counter service package. So you created that package and wrapped it up the way that Service Fabric wants it.
Yeah. So everything's ready to go now.
Okay.
And when I build the application, we actually create a cloud.json file. So what we can do in this file is specify the parameters that we want for connecting to our cluster. So we can connect to either a secure or unsecure cluster. So I had set up a secure cluster before this demo. Just going to close that right there. So I specify the endpoint for the cluster, VS Code demo.sus. Azure.com. You can specify the connection port. And if it was an unsecure cluster, you would leave the client key and client cert fields blank. Mm-hmm. But since this is a secure cluster, I'm just going to quickly bring up the path to my cert. It's located
I'm
right here.
I'm glad that you keep that securely in sticky notes.
Yes, of course. Only easy.
Yeah.
So now we can throw the path in.
Okay.
And now I can bring up the Service Fabric publish application command. And this is going to connect to my remote cluster, mm-hmm. run the install script, and we can see the output in our integrated terminal. So now the install script's running. We'll see the process of our install. So once that's done, we'll be able to go to our Service Fabric Explorer mm-hmm. and see the application actually running. So
47 of 47 complete.
Yeah, pretty much everything's uploaded.
All right.
Just a little moment longer, and
no
it
worries.
Should be
oh,
visible.
There it is. Look,
now
it's
we can see.
Happening. Oh, yeah. So it just got marked as creating. I see it. Oh, and there it is.
Yes. So now our application's deployed on our remote cluster. Since this is just a template application, it doesn't actually do anything. But if it was another application, we could open it up and explore what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
And then removing the application from the cluster is just as easy. Search for Service Fabric, remove application. And this will once again connect to the cluster that I specified in the cloud.json file,
mm-hmm.
run the install script. We can see the progress right here. And we can see on here, it will be updated.
There it is.
So now it's gone.
Now, one of the things that's really cool about Service Fabric is the ability to do rolling upgrades and things like that. So you've installed
right.
and you've uninstalled. Is there ability to upgrade as well?
So I'm working on that right now.
Cool.
In the future, hopefully we can do that. But mm-hmm. at this point, right now, it's just install and uninstall.
So this is kind of your beta release.
Yeah, it's kind of first release, first version. So. Mm-hmm.
And you said that it's going to be up on GitHub soon, and then maybe people who are interested can get in and help out?
Of course, they can create pull requests, they can report bugs, anything they want to do. So.
And did you say that this worked on Macs as well?
Yeah, this also works on Macs. Mm-hmm. So Windows, Linux, and Mac, it's going to work across all of the operating systems.
Did you have another thing you were going to remote desktop into?
Now I'm going to show you how easy it is to debug an application.
Okay.
So I've already deployed this application on my local cluster. It's
okay.
a same C# application.
All right.
And then simply go into debug.net core attach. And then you're going to search for the process that you want to attach to and search for the .NET. So if I see that right here, and I can hit a breakpoint now. So if I throw a breakpoint into my code, we now hit it.
So where are you running that? You're running that in a Service Fabric emulator inside of Bash?
So this is running on a local cluster that's actually running on my local desktop.
Oh, so you're running Service Fabric locally on that desktop?
Yes.
Very
and then
cool.
I can connect to that cluster, deploy my application, and I can debug right from there.
All right, cool. When do you anticipate this will be in the Visual Studio Code extensions gallery?
This should be in the extension gallery by the time.
By the time this video comes out?
Yes.
Cool. So and do we know what it's going to be called? Is it Service Fabric tooling, or what are we calling this?
It should be the Service Fabric extension for VS Code.
Very cool. Do you think that after you're not an intern that you'll keep looking at Service Fabric and working on this extension?
Of course. It's a great extension. I had a lot of fun building it, so I hope I can continue to contribute.
Very cool. Congratulations.
Thanks.
All right. I'm learning all about Service Fabric and how I can deploy and build applications from Visual Studio Code here on Azure Friday.